Hello everyone, thanks for watching this video. So in this video, today we are going to understand that how to read the data from application.yaml file in Spring Boot. In last three video, means 5, 6, 7, okay, we understood that how to read the data from, if you see, last 5, 6 and 7 video, or 8, oh sorry, 6, 7 and 8. We have understood that how to read the data from application.properties file with different condition. For sixth video, we understood that how to read the data from application.properties file, like the data will be list, set, map and the your normal string data and integer data. Followed with that, in seventh video, we understood that how to set the default data in Java class, meaning if the data is not available in your application.properties file, still you can proceed with your business logic by having a default data in your Java class itself. And the eighth video, we understood that even though you have the default data in your Java class, and followed with that you have the value also in application.properties file, but still you want to use the default data or properties file, means some kinds of conditional check that we already understand in video number 8. So these are all 6, 7, 8 is related to application.properties file. So now in this video, we are basically going to understand that how to read the YAML file. So in order to understand this YAML file, I have already created the project from start.spring.io. Okay. So if you see, I have the basic main method, by default main method, and I have the controller also, and it doesn't contain any business logic for now. And also we have the service class, which also doesn't contain any business logic. Followed with that, we have the by default resource folder. If you see, in that resource folder, I have the application.yml file as well as application.properties file. So when both the file doesn't contain any data, so this I need to delete. This is extra thing I don't need for now. So basically thing is that when you are going to create the, or when you are going to generate this project from starter.spring.io, by default it will generate the application.properties for you. So you have to create YAML file by default. So how you are going to create? On resource folder, right click, go to the other and create the file. This is also depends upon IDE to IDE, which IDE are you using, but almost same for the all the IDE. So I am going to create the app.yml, extension is yml file. So as soon as you create, your app.yml got placed here. But if you see here, I have this different icon for yml file. Here is the y icon. Okay, so this, just because of that, I have installed some plugin to read the YAML file in my this Eclipse version. You can have your, you can also download some of the plugin from your marketplace from Eclipse. So that is the anyhow not needed for now. Okay, so basically what I'm trying to tell you is that I have created the project, it doesn't contain any data. So what I'm trying to do is, I just want to get the Spring properties reader. So this project we have created in for video number 6. So if you are directly watching this video, you must watching the 6, 7, 8. So here we have the very clear understanding on the reading the application.properties file. In the same way, we are also going to read the YAML file. So I am copying the project of 6. Okay, so here is the 6 project. Coming to the here, this is the main, I don't need this one. However, this is the default. Coming to the controller, and controller area I just copied this one, and I am going to paste this one into the my this controller. Okay, now this is the service. I need the same service from here. Okay, service does it nothing but just to read the data, and I am placing the code here. Okay, in my project. Okay, so that's all, we are done with the Java. Now we have to copy the properties file data. So this is the application.properties file. I am going to use the same data in YAML file and we will change accordingly. So I have copied the application.properties file data from the old project and copying into the YAML file. However, this is the wrong now, we will do later. Okay. So somehow we loaded the data. Now we have to fix the compilation error. So compilation error is service class and our service class is YAML service. So here I am going to place the YAML service. Okay. And saying that YAML service, fine. And we need to import this one. Okay. And with the reference of this service, I am going to call the getProperties method. Okay. So flow is very simple. There is one book getBookInfo, which is a get mapping. Okay. REST call. So it has one getFromProperties method, and this guy is reading the data from the application.properties file. So as I already told you, there is no changes in the Java in order to read the YAML file. So our Java is now stable. Okay. Now coming to the YAML file. So basically, as I already told you, YAML file and the application file only difference is that the data structure, all the data which is available in YAML file, if you see, this is the structure of application.properties file. But for application.yml file, the structure is different. So how it will be? So for that, if you see, this is the spring. Okay. So basically you should be having the colon here and one space here, and then one colon here, one space here. Okay. So there are some plugin also, depends upon your online plugin or some ID plugin also, who will directly convert your application.properties file to YAML file. So there are one plugin called, I have placed somewhere. Okay. So there are, you can directly Google it, application.properties to YAML converter. So if you see, there are many plugins will come. So like that, this is the one of the plugin. Okay. So if you paste it here, if you paste this data here and then convert it, it will give you the plugin. I mean, it will convert the application.properties file to YAML file. So here it got converted. If you see here, API PoTHI means data got converted in that way, server came in that way. Okay. But the main understanding is that, so when we are converting this one, okay, so what are the common thing that should be coming on top? Okay. So now anyhow we have converted, but we are going to convert it manually. Okay. So I have just replaced the changes. So we are going to convert it manually. So instead of dot, we are putting the colon. Okay. So that's the one thing you need to understand here. And for same, this one also. And here it goes, fine. Now coming to the this one also, this is the manual way to convert from application.properties to YAML file. If you see here, this is the data area, and if you see all the key, this is basically called as key. Okay. Before equal to that, this is called as a key. So in this key, if you see, API PoTHI is the common thing. So YAML file, what they are telling is whatever the common key you have, top common key, just put it to the top. Okay. So all the child will understand automatically. Okay. This is the my parent, something like that. Okay. So this I don't need for now. This I don't need since I have already kept into the parent. See, API PoTHI already becomes the parent. So all the child will understand that. Okay. That is my parent. So fine. and here it go. But if you see, you have some error. No, I don't think so, any error. Okay, but you will get one error that I will tell you when you will get. Okay, anyhow, so now if you will run this project, right click, first let's install. So at least we will understand that, okay, there is no compilation error or no runtime error. So I have did the Maven install, hope this will run, but this actually won't run. Reason is that I have made one intentionally error. So once error will come, I will show you what was the error. Yeah, so which is fine, very expected. If you see, illegal argument exception, meaning that could not resolve API pothi dot book ID. API pothi dot book ID. Okay, so why? Because, sorry, no, book ID is anyhow fine. I don't know why it is not taking. Book ID is fine. And what is the next error? And YAML file dependency injection fan. Okay, which is telling for book ID only the error are coming. Okay, so let us see what is the issue with the book ID. If you see, this one is our converted one, where if you see book ID is 1, 2, 3, fine, it is fine actually, doesn't have any problem. So let's do some little formatting here. Okay, now try to install, run as, okay, first clean the project since this is a configuration change. Sometimes it will read your old configuration also. Okay, so right click, refresh also. So now run as Maven, sorry, Maven install. I don't want to run test. Now right click, run as Maven install. Let us see if any error are coming for book ID or not. But I don't think so, any error should come for book ID. It looks fine. Okay. Error is fine, but shouldn't be for book ID. Okay, see, for book ID no error, for book price, as I already told you, I have made one error intentionally. So book with price, so what is the problem with book with price is, see, book with price is basically key and value pair. Okay, and basically this is the stored by the map. If you will see in our service class, this is just a map here. Okay, so this, with this key, the value will be this one, and this is the map. But for YAML file, this is correct for the application.properties file. But when we are writing into the YAML file, you have to close into the open and single quote. That's what, if you see the generated code also, they must have enclosed this one into the single, and if you see here, open and close. And this one go as a string. Two thing you have to do. This is the only difference between your application.properties file and YAML files. However, this 901 is the integer type, but still we have to put into the double quote. Okay, so basically how this will look is, I will do little here exercise. So basically this look like that. Okay, so this is the proper format. See, this is the open and close, and both are under the single quote. And this is the key, this is the value, this is the key, this is the value, and this is the key, this is the value. Okay, and if you see, key is the string type. If you see here, this is the map. Let me copy it and paste it here. Later we will delete it. Okay, so basically key is the string, however key is the string, which is fine, but our value is the integer and still we are keeping this into the double quote. So that is the syntax to have a hash map into the your YAML file. Okay, so now it should be running. So before run we have to clean at least, so it should not run your, right click run as maven install. Now shouldn't be any error. So only difference with that, you have to do the extra take care of the map. When you have any map, you have to do the extra take care, means your value should be in single quotation and obviously the key and string and integer as same as our application dot properties file. And if you see, it looks fine. Failure 0 means our test run successfully. Yeah, success. Okay, so I don't think so any error should come, but still we have to check it. Okay, so here I am running, right click run as Java application. Yeah, if you see, this got completed and it is running on 8090 port. That's what we have kept into the YAML file. The port should be 8090, where it is C. Port is 8090 and it is running on 8090, which is perfectly fine. Now we have to hit the service, okay, to understand that, okay, really we are able to get the data. So it is running on 8090 localhost 8090/books. So here I already have kept. So if I am press hitting from here, so now let us see the data. If you see, we are able to read the data from YAML file. So though if you see, there is no difference between application.properties file and YAML file. Only thing from Java perspective, only thing is that the data available in YAML file will be in different syntax, okay, and application.properties file in different syntax, but you have to make a extra care when you have some data in map. In YAML file it has to be a single quote. Okay, now this is another assignment for you. Is this, I have just read the data from YAML file. So for YAML file also you need to have the default data into your service class. You have to write the code to have a default data and you have to write the conditional data. So this is again depends upon your video number 7 and 8. Okay, 7 and 8 basically talking about the properties file, and the same thing we have to replicate for YAML file. So this comes under the assignment. Okay, so however we are done and we are able to understand how to read the YAML file data. Okay, yeah, thanks for watching this video.